Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel, AJ's Movie Place. I've got another movie review for you today, that being the new Halloween movie, Halloween Kills. Let's get into it. Okay, so Halloween Kills is the next film in the Halloween franchise. I was going to say the third film. It depends on how you look at it. There's been loads of Halloween films, and they've all taken a different path, so many different timelines. So this is a newer timeline. This is the third part. If you take the first Halloween film, the 2018 Halloween film, and now this film, Halloween Kills. So the film stars Jamie Lee Curtis as Laurie Strode, Pam Grier as her daughter, Anthony Michael Hall plays a character called Tommy, Will Patton returns as the sheriff who was in the first one, all this sort of thing, you know, all these people. There's a wealth of characters, of people that play characters that were in the original, characters from the original Halloween film that have been sort of resurrected for this film. I don't mean resurrected in the literal sense, I mean they're in this film. Obviously different actors playing the parts, this sort of thing, but the grown-up versions of people that were in that. So this film carries straight on from the events of the 2018 version. You've got the house fire, you've got, as you know from the trailers, the fire brigade come to the house, and this is how Michael Myers gets out of the burning house. Let's talk about the story, shall we? So the film opens with some flashback scenes set after the events of the first Halloween, going into 2018's, dismissing everything else, just forget about everything else. It sees Michael Myers being captured, and you've got a character who plays sort of Donald Pleasance role, this sort of thing. It is relevant to this storyline in this. But ultimately, like I said, this film carries straight on from the last one. Oh, Laurie Strode, you pick up with Laurie Strode and she's suffering the wounds that she sustained at the end of the last film. So, yeah, the film sees Mike Myers going on his killing spree again, obviously, in the town. You have Tommy, Anthony Michael Hall, creating some hysteria in the town and riling people up to form a sort of mob mentality to chase down Michael Myers. Only there's a subplot of them doing this, but they're not chasing Michael Myers, they're chasing this other geezer that escaped at the same time as Michael, and they chase him thinking him that he is the killer, and you know, it shows the worst in humanity, this sort of thing, and what we can become when we're scared. And obviously chasing the wrong person, ultimately resulting in this geezer killing himself by jumping from a window from the hospital, blah, 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 blah. All this sort of stuff. The film ends up, it climaxes in the original house from the first Halloween film. Mike Myers goes home, where that happened, killing the two gay fellas that live in the house. There are going to be some spoilers from here on out, if I haven't spoiled it already. I did put up a spoiler flash at the beginning. The film ends with the mob catching up with Michael, and they all give him a beating. He gets shot a few times. He gets stabbed. He gets whacked about with baseball bats and wood, big lumps of wood, all this sort of thing. But ultimately, he gets up, he kills all these people, including Anthony Michael Hall. He ends up back at the house again. He kills Judy Greer. So, for the majority of this film, Jamie Lee Curtis is sidelined. She's just in the hospital, wounded. She doesn't come out of the hospital. She has nothing to do with Michael Myers. That'll be in the next part. No doubt, because she's going to want vengeance for the death of her daughter. The granddaughter's still alive. I don't really know what to say. Did I enjoy this film? Not really. I was sat there, I watched it. I was pretty bored. It was just like, it runs for 1 hour and 45 minutes. I mean, if this sort of film is your cup of tea, then fine, I'm not going to knock you for that. My history with the Halloween films is I've seen the first John Carpenter Halloween film. I don't think it's what people, as good as what people rate it as being. I think people give it a pass just because they want to be part of this. I don't know, they must say this is a good film. It's not a very good film. Back in the day when it was made, it was probably very scary and that sort of thing, because we was coming into the invention of this sort of a horror film. It is the granddaddy of slasher movies, but that doesn't make it the best at all. You know, it paved the way for others, but that means nothing. The 2018, let me jump back. I've seen none of the other sequels to Halloween at all, not really interested in them. In any way, shape or form. I've seen the Rob Zombie Halloweens, Forgettable Fair, I can't remember them at all. Again, not interested to revisit them. I watched the 2018 Halloween film, and to be fair, I quite enjoyed that. I thought it was all right. I thought it was a sort of nice reimagining come sequel to the franchise, going back to its roots and this sort of a thing. So I did enjoy that film. I was looking forward to this one coming off of the back of that, but it sort of falls into sequel territory with it. Doesn't feel fresh. It doesn't feel, you know, it's laughable that you know, characters' motivations, what characters do, it's just all over the place. You wouldn't do this sort of thing. Sort of thing that characters do in this film. It's pretty abysmal, really. I really didn't enjoy it. I didn't have a good time with it. Unfortunately, you know, the 2018 one was good. This one, not so much. I will watch the next one, Halloween Ends, just to see what they do with that, and if it steps it up a bit. But ultimately, yeah, bit of a dud. But there you go. Just my review. My thoughts. There you go. Anyways, AJ, thank you for watching. Please consider hitting that subscribe button. Otherwise, I'll see you all later. Take care, all, and goodbye.